Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss the continuity and end behavior of a function by seeing their graphs. Now, we have already discussed graphs of linear functions and quadratic functions. We see that the graphs of these functions are continuous. It means there is no breakage or gap in the curves of these functions. But sometimes we have graphs of functions which are discontinuous, that is, there exists a gap or breakage in the curve of the function. Now seeing this graph, there are gaps or breaks in the curve. Here we cannot draw it without lifting the pencil. And this is the graph of discontinuous function. That is, we cannot draw the graph of the function without lifting the pencil. Now there are many types of discontinuities. First is infinite discontinuity. In this, absolute value of f(x) becomes greater and greater as graph approaches given value of x. Now here, see the following graph of the function f(x) is equal to 1 upon x minus 1. Here we can see a small change in x near x is equal to 1 on both sides, that is left and right of x is equal to 1, gives a very large change in the value of the function. So there exists infinite discontinuity at x is equal to 1. Next is jump discontinuity. In this, the graph stops at a given value of the domain and then begins again at a different range value for the same value of the domain. Now suppose, if we are given the function f(x) is equal to 1 if x is less than 0 and f(x) is equal to 3 if x is greater than or equal to 0. Now let us see graph of this function. Now see the graph of this function. Here you can see the graph stops at x is equal to 0 and then starts again from x is equal to 0 but at different value of y. Here you can see y is equal to 3 and this line represents y is equal to 1. So this is called jump discontinuity. Next is removable discontinuity. Now, a function has a removable discontinuity if the function is continuous at all the points except at x is equal to c. It is the point in the domain where value of the function becomes undefined and whole appears at the point of discontinuity. Now see the graph of this function where the function is continuous at all the points except at x is equal to 2. So here this whole appears at the point of discontinuity, that is at x is equal to 2. Now if a function is not discontinuous, then it is said to be continuous. That is, a function is said to be continuous at x is equal to c if graph of function passes through that point without a break. Also, you must note that linear, quadratic, exponential, logarithmic, and constant functions are continuous at all points. Now let us discuss continuity at a point. Now a function is continuous at point x is equal to c if it satisfies the three conditions. First is The function is defined at x is equal to c, that is, f of c exists, which means the function should not be undefined at the point x is equal to c. Second is, the function approaches same y values on the left and right sides of x is equal to c, that is, limit of the function f of x where x tends to c exists. And third is, the y value that a function approaches from each side is f of c, that is, limit of function f of x when x tends to c is equal to f of c. Now, a function f of x is continuous on an interval if and only if it is continuous at each number x in the interval. And another tool of analyzing a function is end behavior. Now we will discuss end behavior of polynomial functions. Now the end behavior of a function describes what the y values do when absolute value of x becomes greater and greater. When x becomes greater and greater, we say that x approaches to infinity, or we can say x tends to infinity. And when x becomes more and more negative, then we say x tends to negative infinity. And the same notation can also be used with y or f of x and with real numbers instead of infinity. Now in polynomials, the end behavior is found by checking value of f of x when absolute value of x becomes greater and greater. Now let us consider the following example. Here we have the function f of x is equal to x cubed minus x squared minus x plus 1. Now we will analyze its end behavior both graphically and numerically. Now using graphing calculator, we get the following graph of the function. Here we observe on both ends of the curve, the value of the function becomes greater and greater with increase in value of x. Now on this side you can see this curve approaches to plus infinity as x approaches to infinity, and the curve approaches to negative infinity when x approaches to negative infinity. It appears that limit of the function f of x when x tends to infinity is equal to infinity, and limit of the function f of x when x tends to minus infinity is equal to minus infinity. Now let us analyze it numerically. Now using calculator, we construct the table of values to investigate function values as absolute value of x increases. Now when we examine end behavior, we usually take x as 10, 100, 1000 and so on. And here we obtain this table of values, and we can observe from this table that as x becomes greater, the value of f of x also becomes greater and greater. So, it approaches to plus and minus infinity?
In general, the nth behavior of a polynomial function can be modeled by a function comprising solely of the term comprising highest power of x.
Suppose, for n greater than or equal to 0, p of x is equal to a n into x raised to power n plus a n minus 1 into x raised to power n minus 1 plus so on plus a 1 x plus a naught. Then f of x is equal to a n into x raised to power n has same end behavior. As the function p of x, like in this example which we have discussed earlier, f of x is equal to x cube minus x square minus x plus 1 will have same end behavior as x cube. Now here you can see the term comprising highest power of x in the function f of x is x cube. So this function will have same end behavior as the function containing this single term x cube. Now end behavior of polynomials can be summarized in following manner. Now if an is positive and n is even, for example, see this graph of the function p of x is equal to 2x square, where an is positive and n is even, then p of x tends to infinity as x tends to infinity, and p of x tends to infinity as x tends to minus infinity. Now if an is negative and n is even, for example, see the graph of the function p of x is equal to minus 2x square. Now here an is negative and n is even. So in this case, p of x tends to minus infinity as x tends to infinity, and p of x tends to minus infinity as x tends to minus infinity. Now if an is positive and n is odd, here you can see the graph of the function p of x is equal to 2x cube. So here an is positive and n is odd. Then in this case, p of x tends to infinity as x tends to infinity, and p of x tends to minus infinity as x tends to minus infinity. Now, if an is negative and n is odd, here you can see graph of the function p of x is equal to minus 2x cube. So here an is negative and n is odd. Then in this case, p of x tends to minus infinity as x tends to infinity, and p of x tends to infinity as x tends to minus infinity. So in this session we have discussed continuity and end behavior of a function, and this completes the session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.